The session is being recorded, sir. You can start. Start by presenting. By maximum, sir. You can start by starting the presentation.
Okay. So good afternoon. Am I audible to all?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. So nice of you. Thank you. I'm going to restrict not to on my particular topic, but I will be speaking on a general topic. I have, as in the morning, they have assigned me a topic to speak on the contribution of IGFRI Jhansi in augmenting the feed fodder resources in the country. So just a little bit, I modified my topic and I will be speaking on the current demand scenario and new trends in fodder production. Before I go to my topic, I will like to introduce to all of you about my institute, our institute. This institute was established in 1962. So we have completed 57 years of our establishment. This is 58th year. Headquarter at Jhansi, and we have four regional stations, one at Srinagar, another at Palampur, Himachal Pradesh, and then third one at Abikanagar, Rajasthan, and fourth at Dharwad, Karnataka. These stations have been assigned a particular agroclimatic situations to research and for the technology dissemination and for the human resource development. Dharwad station is looking after the southern part and the coastal areas, whereas the Abikanagar, that Rajasthan station, they are look after the arid and the western region of the country. Our station at Srinagar is specially assigned the responsibility of JNK, Himachal, Uttarakhand, and all similar kind of the homoclimatic conditions where we can have the technology generated at Srinagar can be disseminated in those areas. And then Palampur, we have a little small station where we are especially focusing on the our pasture areas, Himalayan pasture lands. The total strength sanctioned is, our vision is to evolve cultivars, production, processing and utilization technologies for the maximizing production, productivity of the forages and feed to meet the requirement of livestock in eco-friendly manner. This is our total sanctioned strength, 122. We are the second largest institute in crop science division in ICER. And we have published so far more than 3,000 research papers. Number of varieties released 48. And we are producing around 1,200 quintals or 120 ton seeds per year. And we are supplying those seeds we have supplied in last 5 years to more than 24 states of the country, including the Jammu Kashmir and other part. And these are the MU we have signed so far 20. And number of students are trainees, we have trained so far 4,721, and farmers more than 20,000, and even more than. Then if you talk about the impact of the technology, what we have created in the past, our variety, Barsim variety, Bardhan, is one of the largest areas occupying variety in Barsim, covering about 1 million hectare. Another variety, JHO822, a wheat variety, about 0.5 million hectare in the country. From the acrib forages, we have developed many good varieties. African tall variety, single variety, which is ruling in the country. Our Bajra Nepir hybrid variety from the 2NU Coimbatore, BN5, BN4. They are the most important varieties in case of this crop. So this is the in the nutshell about what we are doing, and coming to my topic. This is the presentation outline where I am going to speak about the livestock and fodder status and production technologies. Livestock and fodder status, sources of fodder and status, new models for the fodder production. Then second part will be on the fodder crops improvement and new innovations we are working on that. Where we will be focusing on the recent trends in the variety improvement programs, genomic resources in fodder crops, innovative methodologies we are adapting nowadays. Then fodder seed status and issues. In the morning, I have already submitted that the seed is the most important area where we are looking for. And this third part will be giving a special focus on the fodder seed, where we talk about the status of fodder seed in India, seed chain in fodder seeds, and new innovative approaches which can be adapted for to fulfill the requirement of the fodder seed in the country. So coming to the how the livestock is important, I told in the morning that the livestock is the most important component of agriculture, and it contributes in 1819 it contributed around 14.10% agriculture as such has contributed, and livestock contribution in total agriculture GDP is around more than 30%. Remember, more than 30% alone by the livestock. Milk production, we produce around 186 million tons, and meat production is around 8 million tons, and we are number one milk producer in the world. So this is the share of the various sectors in agriculture and allied gross value added. If you see that the where you will see and you will realize that the contribution of agriculture, although in decreasing in this share of the total GVA, but share of the animal husbandry or livestock is increasing each passing year. And this is also same that agriculture total GVA was in 2023, but it was the 16.4, but now reduced to 14%. But the important thing is that the contribution of the livestock is increasing every year, 22 to 26 in 2012 to 2015. That shows that the how this is going to be important. This data shows the livestock census results of the 2019. We have around 535 heads of the livestock heads, and most important group is your cattle, 192.49 million, whereas the buffalo is second, and the goat is second, and buffalo is third in position, and followed by sheep. All other are the equines, yak, mithun are the little, are the very minor in the number. This is often talked. When we talk, people say that the our productivity of livestock is less. Sir, yes, our livestock productivity is less due to these reasons, where fodder and feed deficiency contributes about 50.2%. That means if you analyze the whole of the region, these are four regions, mainly due to the lack of the feed and fodder. And second is breeding and reproductive. Our breed are poor and they are having the lesser capacity to produce. Diseases is other one, and management aspects is.
Sir, can you, sorry to cut in. Sir, can you resume presenting, because someone started the presentation on their own.
I am unable to understand what you want.
I'm just saying, can you resume presenting? Why? Because somebody came into the room, even though I told them don't start presenting. They start
actually
presenting.
No, that there would be no. There is no any kind of the option available at the window. It asks only to stop sharing. So should I stop sharing?
There would be stop sharing, and can you follow the process which I told you initially? Please, I request again the participants. This is not the manner. Whenever you are given already a list of rules and regulations, you still actually do some mistake which
disturbs
the session. I request all of you not to do start presenting on your own. You are just listen to the session.
This happens when the people are not at very well with the technology. That's I have to again
restart. Sir, can you follow the process again?
So I will do that, no issue. But I have to again go for this.
Start presenting. Choose a window. that problem. Sir, it's on. You can start the presentation and continue.
If this is visible to all.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Okay,
yes.
Fine. So I was on this slide. Let me first. I have already narrated these are the regions, and the most important region is feed fodder deficiency, where we can the most about 50% contributed by this feed fodder deficiency. And once we can provide the those feed fodder in adequate quantity, we can increase those 25 to 30% which is deficiency is there in the about the productivity of the animals. At least 50% we can cover only by the providing the good quality feed fodder. This is the scenario of the fodder in the country. This is the requirement and this is the demand and supply and deficit. Still we have around 2020 we have around deficit of the 30% of the green fodder and dry 11.8%. Even after 10 years if this kind of the effort is going to be continued, around 20% deficit will exist. And that's why this is important to expedite our efforts on this account, and we have to go for the better technologies and varieties and other available technologies for the enhancing the fodder production in the country. So this is the picture which shows that the deficiency scenario in the different part of the state of the India, where you will see that there are some states who are largely having the very high deficit of the this green fodder, including the Jammu Kashmir and the some other part like Uttar Pradesh, other part, even for the green fodder, except for the two states, that is Punjab and Jharkhand, they have the sufficient. Punjab and Chhattisgarh, they have the Jharkhand, they have sufficient quantity of the crop residue available for their livestock. All other states are behaving less or more level of the deficit of for the even for the dry fodder. So these are the different sources of the fodder. You might be knowing that the crop residue contribute about 54%, then cultivated fodder 28% and grassland about 18%. As of now, we are having around 4% of the our cultivable area under the forages. We need to increase up to 10% to fulfill the our all requirement which is exist in the country as of now. So coming to the grasslands is the one of the most important resource of the country. As in the morning I told that we have around 10.15 million hectare, about 3.1% of the geographical area of the country as a grassland or the pasture or the grazing lands. And this can the grassland provides forage to livestock, even including the more than the this whole of the 535 million heads of the livestock. And more important thing, they are also they are also points of the conservation for the different flora and fauna, and they are the also points for the most of the time to recharge the water to maintain the water table in the most of the areas of the world. You will find that they are playing a crucial role. So this is the scenario where if you see that from the the stocking rate and the carrying capacity both are in decreasing day by day, and if you this kind of the things is going to be continued, we are going to lose this valuable resource. These are the potential grazing resources of the country. We have forest about 69.41 million hectare, permanent pasture about 10.90 million hectare, cultivable wasteland 13.66 million hectare, and all other even total common property resources other than the forest are about the 54.01 million hectare. That's a huge resource is available which can be converted into a potential grazing lands or the forage land or the pasture land from where we can go for the supporting our livestock population of the country. Coming to second part of our my presentation, that is the new model for the food fodder production. At IGFRI, in collaboration with the different AICRP centers, we have developed the different farming system based models are the integrated are the enhancing the up living to expedite the our process of having the availability of the green fodder throughout the year. These are the some of the livestock based integrated farming system fodder along with the food crops in the range fed system, exclusive high intensive fodder range system for the peri urban areas, and fodder production through the hearty pasture and silvi pasture system. These are the some of the new model which we have developed, and in the coming slide I will be going to discuss this in detail. We have developed the livestock based integrated farming system. These are the model where all those components which are the prominent in agriculture we have find place. Five model we have developed, and these are the range fed farmers for the irrigated farmers. Out of this, two model we have taken out. One is that range fed crop dominated model, and one is that range fed livestock dominated model, and that is other one is irrigated intensive IFS model. Irrigated dairy based IFS model. These are the two model which we have started out from this model, and we are popularizing these two model on the farmers field. These are the model which we have developed at our institute. Coming to technologies are the round ear fodder production model which we have developed. This is the model which we have developed for the rain fed areas for the arable lands, where if you can see the picture, there are three components, that is serve perennial fodder and the annual fodder are food components. So here the serve is suwaul, then tri-species hybrid which is developed by crossing three species, that is Penicillium purpureum, Penicillium scumulatum and Penicillium glaucum. This is very good, even better than the bajra napier hybrid for the rain fed areas. And then sorghum as a food fodder, and the pigeon pea as a grain crop. So by this model we can go to support up to 2 to 3 milch animals from the 1 hectare area, and this can produce about 30 ton green fodder, and we can make the about 15 ton silage from this, and the benefit cost ratio of this model is around 2.59. In fodder production on the irrigated arable lands, this is another model which we have developed. Here the perennial component bajra napier hybrid, if you can see, and then in between those rows of the rows of the bajra napier hybrid, there is a about 3 meter wide strip where we are taking the cow pea. After harvesting the cow pea, we are taking barseem on this field, and this can produce around 273 ton green fodder per year, and dry matter about 44.3 ton dry matter can be produced. This the model is recommended for the whole of the country except for the South India and for the hills. And this model can support around 7 to 8 adult cattle units. You can say 7 to 8 milch animals, and the BC ratio is 2.41. Okay, this is the another model which we are propagating, and this is a hearty pasture model. In the morning, I was telling that we have developed different model. Whether amla, mango, sapota, even apple, almond, even for the this guava, all those model we have developed, and these are the one of the model where you can say that this amla based model where we are going to have fruit crop, then perennial fodder, and coupled with the that like here we are having the Sanchrus cilaris and the Stylosanthus, and this can support about 2.5 adult cattle units, and this can produce about 7.9 ton dry matter per hectare, so that this can be taken without affecting the yield of the fruit crop. And in some cases we have seen that the yield increase up to the 25%, and this can also happen due to the 2-3 reasons. One, enrichment of organic carbon in the soil. Second, due to the check on the runoff of the water. In most of the cases we have seen that the up to 50% runoff is checked due to the cultivation of the grasses in between rows of the fruit trees. This is a hearty pasture model based on the guava based hearty pasture model which we have also educating, and this is similar to the amla. Then silvi pasture system, this is the one of the system which is very suitable for the areas where you will find that the soil is poor and you cannot cultivate. And you are having the problem of the irrigation there, so you can go for the silvi pasture model. In this model, if you can see that the Ficus infectoria based silvi pasture system, and by this way you can have the forage production throughout the year, and you can manage, for example, green forages from the July to November, and tree leaves it contribute about from the December to January, and then you can have the subabul, which can provide the fodder from February to April, and this can be managed around the whole of the year. In Hardwickia vinata, Ranjan based the hard silvi pasture system, this is for the whole of this this region, that is semi arid region, where including the central part of India, or even going to the southern part, or even the western part, you can include go for the this model, and this model is very useful. Through this model, what we can do, trees can be lopped during the month of January to June, and this can provide about 21%, whereas your bushes and shrubs, they can be provide about 15%, and they can be lopped during the February to April. And grasses or legume can provide if your fodder July to December, and this can may contribute around 64% of the total. And this system can be produced around 10 ton per year dry matter yield, and you can this can be support around 7 to 8 cattle units per year, and provide the throughout year fodder. Okay, coming to that varietal improvement program, that is around your second third part of the lecture where I talk. This is the scenario of the varieties, which in the morning I told that IGFRI along with the ICRP forages has released around 358 varieties of the different forage crop. If you see that these are the list of varieties which we have developed, notified during the period of 2013 to 2019. You will find that Bajra Napier hybrid, Marble Grass, Lucerne, Bajra, Sankar Celeris, Oat, Cowpea, Clatoria, Maize, Bisia, Guinea Grass, Barsim, Rice Bean, almost most of the crops which can be cultivated in diverse kind of the climates, the varieties has been released during this 6 year tenure, and 106 varieties has been identified or notified during this period of 6 year. That means what I wanted to emphasize, that the very good varieties are available of the different forages, and that can be cultivated into different niches based on their requirement and the existing climatic situation and the facilities available in those areas. These are the list of varieties which we have released during the last 5 years. If you can see, these are the institution and these are recommended areas.
Sir, can you resume presentation? Again, somebody came in and started joining as presenter himself.
Sir, this will be very, very difficult for anyone, for any speaker.
Sir, I'm sorry, because participants do not follow rules here. At times I have even mentioned rules, but still they disturb the whole class. Sorry, sir. I request participants to pin up the there's a pin icon, go to presentation, there would be presentation, then there in bracket would be Vijay Yadav. You can pin that up, and ultimately that presentation would be continuously there, because again this person came and started presenting. He has no manners of even reading the rules.
Okay, thank you. And these are the list of the varieties which I told that for your state, respective state, you can find the varieties of different crops. Like here in the oat, these are the oat varieties for the different states. Again, continuing with the oat, so whatever state you belong, you will find the new varieties which have been released in the last 5 years from the different universities and institutions. These are the varieties of the grasses which has been released in last 5 years, including the dicanthium, sankras, atropogon, guinea grass, sitaria, tall fescues, sorghum, seven grass, clytoria, ternacea. In almost all the crops, the varieties have been released in barsim, cowpea, rice bean, lucerne. So by showing this, I wanted to emphasize that there is no problem of any improved variety in the forages. There are number of varieties are available. Only thing that the state government need to be educated that this is a new variety of your state and you should place a demand and you can get the seed from the respective institution from where this variety has been developed. Coming to our next portion, what we are doing right now at IGFRI. Sir, we are using the genomic resources in different crops, and this is the sum of the picture which I wanted to present before you. In guinea grass, we are going for the, this is a crop which is propagated apomictically. That means there is no sexual reproduction. Here we have developed the largest polyd series from 3x to going to 11x. That means different level of the polyd series are available. This is the world largest polyd series in panicum, in guinea grass. Then we have also going to study the apomixis, genetic basis apomixis, and transcriptomic and profiling of the florets in the apomictively sexual lines has been carried out. So we are trying to decipher the genes which are cause the apomixis in these kind of the plants. Similarly in the sankras ciliaris, we have developed the sexual lines. Sexual lines are available in the guinea grass and sankras ciliaris. So anyone who want to go for the further breeding program, they can contact to us in these two crops, because availability of sexual line is the most important and most crucial in the breeding these two grasses. Then barsim, we have the largest number of the germplasm as of now, and we are doing the interspecific hybridization, development of genomic SSR markers, and different gene set for the forage quality. Tilling approach we are following for the functional genomics study, and self-compatible tripping independent genotype has been identified, and we are in the process where we can increase the seed setting in those crops, especially in the barsim. In other crops, core collection we have developed in sorghum and sankras ciliaris, intraspecific hybrid in palmillitans, and palmillitans penicetum scumulatum we have developed. This is a new plant type we developed, where we cross the penicetum scumulatum with the pearl millet, and new crop has been developed, and that has been recommended for the cultivation. We are doing the EST analysis in the red clover and the oats, diversity analysis in global oat germplasm, tissue culture in the stylocynthia, saima, dicanthium, oat, bajra nephrabit, and we are also going for the biofortification studies in oats, and we have identified the high zinc accumulating genotype in this crop. Similarly, for this oat also, this is the where we are working. We have gone for the genetic diversity studies in the oats, and we have also the development of the fertile variants of the bajra napier hybrids and in vitro plant regeneration. We are working on this line, and we can develop a fertile bajra napier hybrid, which is our dream to do that, and our scientists are working on this line, where we are crossing the tetrapolyad bajra napier hybrid with the tetrapolyad napier. You might be knowing that the bajra napier hybrid is triploid, which is being cultivated. Our focus is to develop the tetrapolyad bajra. We have did it, and we are crossing with the tetrapolyad napier. So get a tetrapolyad bajra napier hybrid, which may be having the seed bearing capacity, so that this will reduce the transportation problem which we are facing, that during the transportation you require huge quantity need to be transported from one place to another place. And we developed the first single cut barsim. You can see that this is a barsim variety, Jhansi barsim single cut 1. This is a variety which is having the high dry matter accumulation, about 10% more than dry matter content in compared to the all other varieties. And it had the seed yield around 12 quintal per hectare, and this is a tripping independent. This is a tripping independent where this variety has been developed. And along with this, these are some other alliance where we are working, where we are going for the tripping independent mutants, and we are developing the stages of these are different stages of tripping independent, and this is mutant florets. All those things we are working. Guinea grass, we are trying to develop the settling tolerant lines, and This is the sexual lines, and this is an improved sexual line we have developed, that SPM 95 we have developed, and 77 we have already registered with the NPBGR. And this is the pictures of the our the highest. I told that we are having the world largest Pilates reach. This is the picture of the Pilates reach which we have. Then new forage crops. But morning, Dr. Baksiram was telling that we are also having collaboration with them. These are the new forage crop developed. You all are knowing about the Bajra napier hybrid. Here, this was developed by crossing the Bajra as a female parents and Purpureum napier as a male parent. This having the advantage of perennialty, high biomass and high quality. But what we have did, we developed another TSH, three tri-species hybrid, three species animal, Penicillium glaucum, Penicillium purpureum, and the Penicillium scumulatum. This had the capacity, this had the perennialty, drought tolerance, winter hardiness, and high biomass. So this required lesser water as compared to Bajra napier hybrid. And we have developed another hybrid, inter-species hybrid. This was by crossing the Bajra and the Penicillium scumulatum, Penicillium glaucum with Penicillium scumulatum. This is a new plant which has been developed and released from the IGFRI last in 2018. This is having the perennialty, drought tolerant, winter hardiness, and good quality fodder. And we are propagating this material, and we are disseminating this technology into the same arid areas where there is problem of the moisture exists. This is the Dr. Baksiram was telling that this is the new work we have initiated in along with the collaboration of the Sugarcane Breeding Institute, Coimbatore, where we are having the saccharum into sorghum hybrids, saccharum into GIA hybrids, saccharum into Penicillium hybrids. That means sugarcane into sorghum, sugarcane into maize, sugarcane into Bajra. These are the lines which we have got from the SBI Coimbatore. They are testing, evaluating these lines for the quality silage making, and in the coming time probably we will be able to identify some lines which may be perennial and suitable for the silage making. So this is the area where we are working. This is your future research areas where we are looking for the biofortified fodder varieties, tripping independent self-compatible bursine. We are going to use the association mapping and QTL mapping for water use efficiency in the fall and in the different traits. And for the forest traits in our pollinator line, the different bursine, especially in bursine, genetic improvement of this, and in the grasses where there is a major problem is synchronous and scattering tolerance. We are working on this line and strengthening the grass breeding by using the sexual line. This is the area where we are giving the due emphasis, and candidate genes are only controlling apomixis of sexuality. We are working, and we in the coming time probably we will be able to decipher the genetic background of the apomictic and why that is a plant apomictic and why it becomes sexual. And fertile hexaploid Bajra napier hybrid, as I have already narrated. Okay, this is the three part of my presentation. The last part of my presentation is on the fodder seed. This is the scenario where we are looking for. And if you see that the whole of the forage crops, the seed is the most important chain and biggest chain, because you will not find except for the 2-3 crops like the sorghum or the pearl millet, or in some cases in the bursim and oat, where the existing seed chain is well established seed chain is available. In most of the other crops, the seed chain is not available, especially in the range grasses and range legumes. So this is the crop where the seed chain exists. In kharif we have sorghum, pearl millet, maize, cowpea, guar. In rabi, bursim, oat and lucerne and lathyrus. Remember, we are cultivating more than 16 or 17 crops as a fodder in the different part of the country. Seed chain in those crops are not existing in the country, and this is the one of the biggest lacunas. These are the crops where the seed chain are not available in range grasses. And seed is either seed is generally available only for the fall. Following, I are available for only these cultivated crops and range grasses, and for other seed chains are not available. And moving ahead with this this attention on this, we have developed the seed stand for these four in the last 1 or 2 years, and we have submitted to the DSC for the inclusion in the blue book, Lazurus syndicus, Clytoria ternacia, Desmanthus bergedus, and Stylosynthes hamata. We have did in the last few years. And this is the other crop you might be more interested to know, that we are working on the development of the seed standards in grumas, dactylis, ryegrass, tall fescue, and red clover, which are most important for the hills. And we are working on this line, and we will are hoping to get a seed standard, well established seed standard, in the coming 1 or 2 years. So this is estimated seed requirement of the grasses, legumes, and fodder trees. If you see that we require about 13,500 tons of the grasses, legumes 31.3, fodder trees are served 1.83. And if you ask for me that is any, what is the quantity of seed is available, almost I can say even less than 5% seed are available, quality seeds are available. Reason being, no agency coming forward for the grass seed production, although there is huge demand. What I can say, being the head of the seed technology and the head of this institution, there is very huge demand exists for the grasses seed, and we are not being able to supply because we can produce very limited quantity. There are number of agencies like Forest Department, National Highway, Land, the NMDC, and number of the corporation which require the grass seeds. But grass seed production is not being taken on the scientifically or by using the seed chain basis in the any grasses, and that is the one of the biggest problem. No breeder foundation certified seed chain exists in the grasses, and this required to be established very on the urgency basis. These are the estimated seed requirement of the major cultivated crop. If you can see that we require 1,36,700 tons of the seeds, certified seeds of the different crops, and if you see that the quantity available, that is very 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 meager quantity is available. And these are the important forage crops and their seed chain. In maize, there are 3 varieties, cowpea about 6 varieties, rice bean 2 varieties. In oat, we are having the maximum number of the varieties, where the varieties of the different institution find place in the seed chain. Lucerne only 3 varieties, and Barsim there are the few varieties are available, and these are the breeder seed production and in the different in last 6 years which we have carried out through the ACRIP and other partners. These are the major crop where the seed chain was developed, and seed chain was
hello, hello sir, have you have accidentally muted yourself? Can you unmute yourself?
Now I am audible or not?
Yes, you are audible.
Yeah, thank you. So this is the demand for the certified seeds, and we require about 1,36,700 tons of the seeds, and the only availability is around 9,500 tons. That means there is about 93% deficit exist in fodder crops seed. This is a very huge quantity. In no other crop you will find this kind of the scenario. Breeder seed level, even for at the certified seed level, there is very huge quantity demand exist, and we are not being able to fulfill that demand because we are not getting adequate requirement at the state government level, at the builder seed level, and then subsequently at the certified seed level, because the seed chain are not being maintained. This is the other issue which we have been talking a lot, that is the import of the fodder seed versus other seeds. These are the other seeds, total fodder seed. If you say that these are the total seed for sowing, these are the about 80, 70 or even 75% even 50% seed 18-19 was only forest seeds, and about only two crops, that is about your barsim and rye grass. This was the important forage crops which for which seed has been imported from the outside. This is barsim seed import. If you can see that the barsim seed import through our intervention, it now have started reducing, and we are hopeful in the coming 5 years we are going to completely check the import of the barsim seed, and we can make our country self-reliant, atmanirbhar for the barsim seed. This is the barsim seed study where we have carried out. I'm not going in detail, but what I wanted to narrate here through this slide, that the in barsim seeds, the whatever seed is being sold in the market, that is very very poor quality, and there is only physical purity exists around the 18.28%, and germination only 4% against the 80%. There are few sample which we have collected from the market. We have been surprised to see that. This is rye grass seed imported in the country. Rye grass seed import is increasing every year. So like the state, our like your union territory, Jammu Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, where the rye seed production can be taken, even Punjab can be taken, are the larger quantity. We can see and we can increase the seed production, the rye grass, because the import is being increased in every year. So what is the opportunity of the forest seeds? Forest seeds, as I have shown you, that there is a lot of deficit, around more than 90%. Seed only for only few crop is being imported. So most of the seed for the other crop is being fulfilled from the domestic production. So this is a plus point. Development of the new model for the food fodder production is arable and non-arable lands where we require the seed, and you can produce seed, quality seed can be produced. Presence of the large area under the baseland, about 68 million hectare, and we are targeting those baseland for the fodder production, and this is possible only when you have the seed, quality seed for this. Rejuvenation of 11 million hectare of the grasslands, and very few public sector organization like IGFRI, Kajri, Animal Husbandry Department, and absence of the seed chain in the range grasses. What I would like to through this slide, emphasize that this is an area where farmers, entrepreneurs, our new startup can be taken up, and those are the expected to be more successful because huge demand exists in these crop and there is no supply. So through this, we can develop a new entrepreneurs in this area, and these are these very number of the organizations which require the seeds: National Highway Authority, mining corporations, forest departments, and the number of other state government, and they require the seed of those crops for the different purpose. Range species also require for the ecosystem development or eco restoration, biodiversity park, eco park. Export potential of tropical species to Middle East and countries exist where we can produce seeds, and we can export those seeds to the Middle East and even the African countries, because they our varieties which are suitable for this region can be grown successfully in those areas. So these are the constraints and these are the opportunities in the different crops. What I wanted to emphasize, that the lot of the production constraint, these are the indeterminate, uneven maturity, seed settling, dank seed, lodging, seed dormancy, number of the things. But this is the opportunities: serve the ecological needs, suitability to all kinds of the situation, wealth of the genes for the various stresses and apomictic research in the, and high cost of the seed, and lot of the requirement by various agencies. So this is the time where we can think. This is the time where you plan for the climate change scenario. The grasses or the forage crop cannot be ignored. And in the end, what I would like to emphasize, that the we have to develop the seed chain. We have to go for the consortium of the state government, central government, and different agencies, ICR and state government are the state universities. And where we have developed a consortium, we can strengthen our emphasis on the fodder, we can involve the private sector, and we can start the new startup on this area. Participatory seed production has been very, very successful at this institute level, and we are producing a good quantity of seed through the participatory seed production. So these are the some of the new things which I wanted to present before you. These are the some of the innovations which we have made in the last few years, where we are developed the in vitro maturation technology, high density nursery in bajra napier hybrid, in vitro rooting of bajra napier hybrid, mechanical deep flapping machine, and many more we have did. And Barsim, we are also doing this, and we are trying to pursue with the state government or the planning authorities to reduce the import and promote the our own production in the country. So thank you. This was the nutshell what I wanted to emphasize, discuss with you, that where IGFRA exists, and I hope that there are many of my colleagues who are going to speak in the coming time, and they will speak another in detail on those topics which I have taken not in detail. So thank you for your patienceful hearing. If you have any query, you are most welcome.
Any questions from the participants, please ask, sir. One by one, please.
Sir.
Yeah, please tell me.
Assistant Professor, I'm working in Telangana Veterinary University, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, a lot of foreign varieties like from Brazil and from Thailand, Pak Chang Wang, one that Super Napier, they are coming to our state, especially Telangana, Andhra and Tamil Nadu, and they are propagating like anything. Is there any research is going on this water varieties like Super Napier, and other grasses?
That's there is nothing like Super Napier. Remember this. Because Napier, you might be knowing that the elephant grass or the Penicetum purpureum is not a cultivable, and that is having very poor quality of the fodder. So whatever Napier is coming in the market, they are the basically Bajra Napier hybrid. And whatever is being sold as the Super Napier, that is nothing like any Super Napier. And we have tested many varieties developed from the our university, like Tamil Nadu Agricultural University, are the from the Anand, are from the East Institute, they are having the even better quality. Some of them is claiming, there are many YouTube small videos are on the uploaded on the YouTube by the various people. They are claiming that they have the 20 or 25% of the crude protein. That is impossible. We have seen the crude protein content is even lesser than some cases, less than the CO5 or CO6 varieties of our public sector variety bred by Tamil Nadu Agricultural University. So don't be confused, sir. They are the only Bajra Napier hybrid, and they are the even our varieties for the southern part of the country, or CO5 or CO6 is better than even the Super Napier. Only thing that you have to provide the required fertilizer and the irrigation condition, other things which is required recommended for that variety. So Super Napier is nothing. No Super Napier or nothing. No, we will not find any literature, anything super plant or anything has been developed in any part of the world. Yeah. Anyone else like to ask any question?
Sir, good evening, sir.
Any other question, please?
Sir, good evening. May I have a question? Yes, sir. Myself, Dr. Raj Kishore,
yeah,
sir, from Animal Nutrition, Veterinary College. So the same question I'm going to continue, sir. It was being propagated under the name Thai Napier or Super Napier. And as you told, it is nothing more than that, like 4-5. Co-6 has also been released, sir.
CO6 and CO5. Now the Tamil Nadu Agricultural University has released new variety CO6. And you can ask to our builder, Dr. Babu is there. You can ask from the Tamil Nadu Agricultural University. Yeah. They can provide the material from the Tamil Nadu. CO6 is a very good variety. and you will find those material from the Tamil Nadu agriculture ministry. If you feel any trouble getting the material, you can write an email to me and I will help you getting the material from the Tamil Nadu agriculture ministry.
Thank you, sir.
Any other questions? Sir, on behalf of NADCL team, we'd like to thank you, and also on behalf of the participants, we'd like to thank you. Thank you for your time and valuable insights into the subject. Thanks a lot. Now the session may be considered over. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
We can all leave. We can all leave the meeting now. Thank you, sir.
Hello, Majid sir. Hello. Majid sir.
Yeah, hello.
Sir, yahi link rahegi kal ya kahin hogi?
I'm not able to hear you. आप बताएंगे आप क्या कहना चाहते हैं?
ये लिंक से आज हमने जो ज्वाइन किया यही लिंक रहेगी?
नहीं नहीं, सेशन चेंजेस, कल का लिंक आगे फिर से नया आ जाएगा, उसके बाद सुबह के टाइम का लिंक अलग आ जाएगा, दोपहर के टाइम का लिंक अलग आ जाएगा. आपको लिंक हम दे देंगे 10-15 मिनट पहले, लिंक विल सेंड द लिंक 10-15 मिनट्स अर्लियर. बट आई हैव अ सिंपल एंड हम्बल रिक्वेस्ट टू ऑल ऑफ यू, because me does not allow me to do this feature, that I cannot make something a presenter and keep him a presenter. I ask everyone, join the session, don't present, and mute your microphones and also turn off your cameras, because this session is being recorded. Thank you. Any other question?
Sir, PPT milega sir?
PPT, I'll ask sir to share the PPT if possible, then we'll share the. We'll do one more thing. We will do record. The recording will be uploaded on YouTube. So we'll share the link of the video itself.
Okay, sir. But we need PPT also, sir. Why? Because a lot of data is there. We need data since we are working on the border.
See, my point is, this is individual research, and this is the prerogative of the speaker to share their presentations or not. We'll ask them, and if they are happy to provide, and we'll be happy to share. Thank you.
Sir, any class next?
Only two sessions are today. Okay. We may all leave the session. We may all leave the session.
Only this. Tomorrow, please kindly start the program at right time, sir. Why? Because today it is already 12:30 we started.
See, I understand the concern, and we also try to do the same. Problem is, the issue is, at times the resource person has some network issue, or at times is not familiar with Google Meet.
Thank you, sir. Bundle full, sir. Bundle full. Majid sir, yeah, please. Hello. Thank you, thank you. Hello. Thank you, thank you. Hello. Majid sir, yeah, that's it. I just write a question in chat box, either I call or I just write a question in the chat box, but the expert is not answering me. Sorry, sorry. Anyways,
what we'll do is we'll redirect the question to sir as well. No problem.
Hello.
Yeah, please go ahead.
Sir, I just asked a question in the chat box, and the expert is not answering me.
He might not have seen the chat. That might have been the issue. Anyways, we'll try to email him the question if possible.
Okay, sir. Can we write the question in chat box, or either I directly chat with him?
Both ways are acceptable, depends on the mood of the expert. At times the expert is just focusing on the voice. At times you can do that, or you can ask the question in chat as well. But at times the resource person is looking at the chat itself.
Sir, your Samut sir, your question, is there any multi-cut variety of maize? Is it your question?
Yes, sir.
Sir, there is no multi-cut variety of quad or maize, sir. But there is a, multi-cut variety like, variety is there, that is called a EOC. It is a multi-tillered, not multi-cut variety. There is no multi-cut variety of maize quarter, sir. Since we are working in quarter, we are able to answer your question.
Okay, sir. Nice to answer me. Sir, can you send your number on chat box?
I am Ramakrishna.
Thank you a lot. Now we may leave the room so that we all can go about with our own business. Thank you. Best of luck. See you all tomorrow.
Good afternoon, everyone.